Okay, this is my first attempt at a makeup tutorial because some of y'all have requested this of me. I am by no means an expert in makeup, but I have learned a lot during the pandemic by watching a lot of YouTube videos and just figuring out what works for me. And, you know, I love you guys and just wanted to show you how I do it. So first of all, skincare routine. I don't really have like a skincare routine. I have time on my side. I just turned 39, so you know, I'm still pretty young. So I know that that is a big factor in how my skin looks, and I might have to start doing something else when I get a little older. But for now, really, I just try to wash my face as little as possible, to be honest, and it probably depends on person, what kind of oil you have, but I find that just my natural oil doesn't clog up my pores or anything. When I do have to wash my face, like when I have makeup on, and I use makeup remover, then I wash my face after, and I use this guy. It's like a gentle wash with like very fine particles for scrubbing to help scrub some of the makeup off and out of the pores and stuff, and it plumps up your face a little bit because it has hyaluronic acid. That's what it's called. Hyaluronic acid. And then after I do that, anytime I have to wash my face or remove makeup, I put on, this is my very cheap skin serum. It's coconut oil, just unrefined virgin coconut oil. When I'm feeling real fancy, I will mix up some, melt and mix together some actual cocoa butter, which I keep in my fridge, just like food grade cocoa butter. And I don't mind the way it feels. It feels oily or whatever, but I just slather it on, leave it on overnight, and then it, you know, makes my skin pretty soft and kind of absorbs by the next day. So then I start with my base, usually a Clinique foundation. I find it just works well with my skin. I have sensitive skin, so I try to use stuff that is for more sensitive skin. And I just put some on my really old, needing to be replaced makeup sponge thing. And start in the areas where I feel like I need more foundation, where I have a lot of redness. It's just the natural tone of my skin, but I don't like it, so I'm gonna cover it up. And I find, I tried this after watching some video tutorials on makeup, and after like decades of just using my fingers, and I think you can get like a thinner layer using this, and it makes it a little smoother. I don't like to put my makeup on super thick in this particular foundation. I always use one with SPF, and in the summer I always use a very high SPF sunscreen on my face, like SPF 50 or higher. I have very naturally pale skin, and I know I already have a ton of sun damage from years of being a lifeguard, so I'm trying to just head that off. Just making sure like I'm getting it all in all the cracks and crevices of my face. Trying not to get too much up here or on my forehead because I have these lines on my forehead, and I don't like to put makeup up there because it just kind of, it doesn't look great when I get too much makeup up there. I'll do just a tiny bit sometimes. But otherwise, I like to just leave my forehead natural. Okay. Next, I usually do my eyebrows. I think this is like the biggest thing that's changed in pandemic times is watching a lot of videos on how to emphasize eyebrows and fill them in. I have pretty thin eyebrows, so right now I'm just using an eyeshadow. Sorry, it's like hammered. The girls like dug into it. Most of my makeup looks like that. I'm using this color that's like a pale brown. It's very close to my natural hair color, which is like an ashy pale brown. And whatever thing I'm using, whatever product I'm using, sometimes it's like brow mascara for blonde hair basically, or some, I have little liquid brow liner things I use sometimes, but lately this has been my thing. I kind of draw, I want to extend my eyebrows a little bit toward the center. So I'm kind of like drawing an outline of where I would like them to go with the eyeshadow. And trying to just do like wispy little strokes. In this area, I'm going to kind of turn my brush in the direction of my actual hairs and make these little sweeping motions down. Don't want it to look too perfect, otherwise it won't look as natural. And then I'm just kind of darkening in the areas where there actually is hair. It's a little dark. I might have to lighten it up in a moment. I like to extend this down a little bit. I do have very tiny hairs down here, but to extend the line a little bit past that. Because big, substantial brows are like the thing right now. I really do think it changes your face. Alright, so that one's pretty good. Now I have to try to get this other one symmetrical. That's the tricky part. Okay. So believe it or not, I'm not even done with my eyebrows yet. The next step I like to do, and I want to emphasize that makeup's different for everybody. It depends on your eyebrow shape, your eye shape, all that. I like to put a little concealer to kind of outline the eyebrows. So I have this ELF concealer stick, and I try to just draw a line above the eyebrows. It just helps strengthen the lines that I've made, especially because I'm not using super dark shade of eyeshadow. I don't have super dark hair naturally, so that would look weird on me. So this helps define the brows. I think they call it carving out the brows. I'm not up with like the TikTok generation lingo. And then I just kind of try to blend it in, sometimes with a sponge, sometimes just with my finger, just trying to smudge it basically. I think that looks pretty good. Right, now moving on to my eyes, and I was a little heavy on my lids with the foundation, so I'm actually gonna try to take a little bit of that off. I don't really like to have foundation on my eyelids because I usually put eyeshadow on there, and I don't know, it gets real messy if I have foundation on there. Alright, so I'm using a brown eyeliner. This is No Budge retractable eyeliner from ELF, and the color is coffee. I tend to use like brown colors on my eyes, in my the eye area because I have pale skin and pale hair. So black can look jarring. If you have darker hair or darker complexion, black might work better for you. So I'm just outlining the top of my eyes, getting as close to my eyelashes as possible. And this is just my personal eye routine. Depending on the shape of your eyes, different things are going to look nice for your eyes. I like to not really do liner on the bottom. If I do, I do just a tiny little bit and do heavy liner on the top. That's what looks best, I think, with my shape of eyes. I have a big eyelid, a big, like, heavy eyelid. So I actually started looking up makeup tutorials for women that have this same shape eye. Because, depending on your shape of eye, you may want to emphasize different parts of your eye, and different things can work better for different eyelid and eye shapes. I find that a winged eyeliner works good for my eye shape. And part of my YouTube makeup exploration was like trying different things and just taking a look at how I look, not just in the mirror, but like taking selfies on my phone and looking at them, because that I think it gives you a more objective eye when you see a photo of yourself versus like looking in the mirror. I always think I look better in the mirror than on in a photo. Right, so and I try to go up from this bottom edge, the waterline of my eye. I try to follow that line up with my eyeliner and head toward the end of my eyebrow. And I don't have to worry about this doing being too perfect because I am going to use liquid liner later too. This can be a little smudgy. Alright, now I'm just going to put a tiny little bit under my eye. Oh, also, this look I'm doing today too is for going out. It's not for Zoom. For Zoom classes, I'll go like a little bit heavier on everything on the makeup because on Zoom in front of the webcam with the bright light on all day, it washes me out and like I feel like I have to have a lot of makeup on for it to look like I'm wearing any makeup at all. So I have to be a little bit heavier. I'm just doing this eye the same. This eye is actually harder for me because I'm right-handed, so the angle of the eyeliner is different. All right, so this is another day of trying to do this tutorial. So this middle section is going to be a different day than the first and last section because my computer decided not to record that middle part, or the video file is corrupted. Photo booth, thanks. So I did the one eye. Now I'm just going to do the other eye. This side is much harder for me because I'm right-handed. So I always do the side that I'm better at first. Try to just get that established. And then go and try to match the second side to the good first side. I'm getting as close to the lash line as possible here. I'm using short strokes just to kind of gradually paint the layers of this on, and I do have aging skin, so it's a little loose. It's not super taut, so the smaller strokes help it to help me to get the right shape here because there's wrinkles as well, and I'm trying not to let the wrinkles affect the shape of the liner. That's also why I think I like this smudgy first layer of liner because on older skin, smudgier can often look a little more refined. If you have more like stark lines, high contrast lines, it can kind of accentuate the little wrinkles of the skin or the texture of the skin. Whereas if it's smudgy, that kind of disguises it a little bit. Okay, I think I always end up with this one thicker, so I have to come back here and fill this part in and make this wing a little thicker. Good chance to even out any asymmetry in your eyes as well. If you can get your liner and your eye makeup symmetrical, it can help disguise the asymmetry of the shapes of your eyes. makeup at the corner of my eye from yesterday. Lovely, huh? All right. I think that's pretty well even. So after doing the soft smudgy liner, I like to do my eyeshadow next. And this is a new thing for me. I didn't used to wear eyeshadow, but I like these sort of neutral colors now. I have this NYX Ultimate Edit Ombre Petite Shadow Palette. And so it's like these warm brown colors. A couple are shimmery. I don't even remember what this one is. My children destroyed it. And then there's some matte red and more brown browns, and then a light sort of nude color. I took some experimentation with this, but the light nude color actually comes out slightly darker than my skin tone, so I like to take this lighter color and sort of add it to the area under my brow, but not quite down to my lid, just sort of like the upper area. It covers up the veins a little bit in my eye area, and it's going to help blend the other color that I'm going to use. So from just under the brow and then into the crease. I'm trying to have a light touch. Sometimes I also use it to contour my nose. My nose is asymmetrical. It leans to the left. You know, if it was more symmetrical, the point would be more to the middle here. So one of the things I do sometimes is just contour my nose a tiny little bit using that same nude color. And my nose is shiny today. I'm gonna have to use powder on it. Probably all the stress of the children. It's not a work day today. And I'll actually put a little down here too, just to de-emphasize my nostrils. Make my nose look a little smaller. And underneath here as well. It's very subtle. On Zoom, I'll use sometimes darker colors to do that step, because the makeup just doesn't show up as well on Zoom. You can use more and it looks like less. All right, now I'm using this shimmery reddish-brown color and putting it toward the outside corner of my eyes on my lid. And working it about to the middle of my eyelid. And then I'm going to just gently rub a little bit up here in the crease. Okay. And then I'll do the same on the other side. But this is my where I try to make my eyes look more symmetrical. Because this eyelid is a little smaller than this eyelid. So I'm going to do the same thing. Start in the corner. Work my way inward on the lid, but I'm going to work a little further in so that more of this eyelid is darker. It'll make it look a little smaller. And then I actually go up a little bit further into the crease than my right eye. That'll help sort of camouflage or make that eyelid look a little smaller. So I sort of discovered this technique of using the darker shadow to the outer edge just by watching YouTube tutorials and looking up tutorials specific for my eye shape. I have very large lids and like low eyebrows, and there's other ways to describe my eye shape. I can't remember, but literally going on YouTube to look up makeup for this particular eye shape is what has helped me. And then just experimenting. I've tried liner different ways. I've tried heavy liner on the bottom. I've tried liner on the waterline on tops and bottoms, and just discovered that this particular look is best for my face and my eyes. I'm most happy with this out of any of the looks I've tried, and I've tried a lot. So now I'm getting out my liquid liner. This is Revlon Color Stay Skinny Liquid Liner, and the color is Mahogany Flame. It's like a dark brown, but it's got a metallic look to it as well. And I'm going to put that along the top of my lash line on my lid. And And this is a little bolder than the smudgy eyeliner I was using, so it's going to darken that lash line. And I want it to kind of come in the middle of the wing that I've drawn so that it's the wing's still smudgy. Always using short, gentle strokes to kind of carve out the line. This part is so hard, I'm like holding my breath. I chose the brown color because my hair and my face are very pale, and using darker colors just doesn't suit my tone as much. If I had darker hair and or darker complexion, I could get away with more black colors, but I think that the slightly lighter colors just look better, more sophisticated on my coloration. All right, so that's it for a liner. Gotta do blush now. I use this Clinique Cheek Pop, Blush Pop, Heather Pop is the color. And it's like sort of it's in between cool and warm. It's sort of a neutral pink blush, which I think works with my face. My tone is, I think, kind of neutral. I could go either warmer or cooler. And so I'm putting it just on the apples of my cheeks, like the part that's kind of round when I smile, and then pulling it up along my cheekbone, almost to my ears, and then up on my temples a little bit too. And I do go kind of heavy in my blush because I'm fair. I like to add a little color to my face, and especially with the pink hair, I can get kind of washed out. Extra blush is good. In the summer, when I'm more tan, I'll sometimes do a little contour down here, like a little slightly darker color to emphasize my cheekbones, but I really don't think it looks good this time of year when my skin is paler. I don't have any tan at all. It just doesn't look natural on me. Can't emphasize enough to just like experiment and try things that are appropriate for your face type. YouTube tutorials. Alright, now somewhere in the house probably is a highlighter, like a highlight powder. It's really cool. It's like bright pearlescent with like sort of blue tones in it. I have no idea where it went. It either fell out of the closet or, you know, rolled into some laundry or the children took it. I don't know. But so my backup for right now is this shimmery light pink eyeshadow. It's Maybelline. I don't know what color it is. The color has worn off. It's pretty old. But I like to put a little bit of this in the corners of my eyes and then up under my brow. And I would have used my highlighter, the highlighting powder for that. But like I said, I don't know where that is right now. I'm not about to buy more until I know for sure it's gone. So I'm going to give it a little time. This makes my brows look higher than they are, and it at the corners it emphasizes the corners of my eyes and that part of my eye that I think like it's a nice shape. And I'll even bring a little bit up sometimes onto the lid, just toward the corner. And then I'll use a little bit on my cheeks as well, just sort of at the top of the the cheekbone. The other stuff was better, but this does the trick a little bit. Just adds like a little sheen. Super fashionable right now. All the Instagram models are using it. And then I'm going to do my lips. I'm going to line them with this NYX Professional Matte Lip Liner crayon, and the color is Moonwalk. It's a sort of a plum brown, very purpley sort of brown color. And I'm lining just to the outside of my natural lip line. And try not to go too far outside because I don't want to look at, like, I don't want to look cartoonish. Especially in real life, it's easy to tell when you've overlined your lips. But if you do just a little bit, it's a little bit subtle. Cheaper than lip injections. And you can wash it off. Another place if you have asymmetrical lips, it's a good way to kind of even them out. This is a little out of order because of my having to do this on multiple days, but also use mascara. This ELF mascara is kind of like my drugstore backup for when my Clinique mascara is not around. I need to go to Macy's to get more Clinique mascara. That's my favorite. But this stuff is like okay. It's kind of sticky, so it does add some volume and length, but it's not as nice as Clinique. So I'm just doing mascara on all my lashes. Oh shoot, I did a little dot. I gotta clean that up. Top and bottom. Trying to make sure I get right down to the base of the lashes. I have pretty short lashes, so I like to play up this area and put on falsies when I have the time and patience. The hardest time getting this even, like, symmetrical. Sometimes doing that helps. And then if I'm doing Zoom, I'll use this Physician's Formula Maru Maru butter. I got it because it has SPF. It's like a lip. It's a glossy lipstick with SPF. It looks shiny, and this color is Mauve into Brazil. But it's kind of dark for just being in person. So I also have this Clinique lipstick I like to use. It's a Chubby Stick Moisturizing Lip Color Balm, and it's Whoppin' Watermelon. And just fill in my lips. Rub to blend the liner line, and then where is it? Okay, got it. And then I have I love this stuff, Plump Potion, Physician's Formula Plump Potion Lip Gloss. It actually makes your lips like plump up temporarily. Good for selfies though. So I'm just going to do lashes, and then I'll let my hair down and be done. All right, so these lashes I'm using today, I've used like a million times. I really should clean more some of the glue off, but they're just like drugstore lashes. And I trimmed them a little bit, so they're about like three quarters of the eye. They don't go all the way to the inside corners of my eye. They just stay to the outside a little bit. And I'm just gluing them on with some clear lash glue, duo lash glue. You can use any brand lash glue with any brand lashes, honestly. So, put the glue on them. I'm trying to put like a row of glue on the part that's going to be touching my eye, and then you're supposed to wait 30 seconds. So I'm going to try to do both of these. Are starting to look bigger. It feels tingly when the stuff is like activated and plumping up your lips. I don't have Botox or any of that stuff. I try not to furrow my eyebrows because I know that area can get wrinkly real fast, and I try not to smile a lot. I'm just kidding. So I'm gonna place these. I use my tweezers to try to place these right up against the top part of my eye. Looks pretty good. I might have to darken this line of my eyeliner to make it look more natural. I'm kind of pinching my natural lashes and my falsies together. Right. Oops. I always get the second one in the wrong spot. Take it off and redo it. Okay. That's pretty good. All right, so I'm going to take a little black liquid eyeliner. I can find it in my kit. Yeah, I got some here. So this ELF black liquid liner, and I'm just gonna try to draw a very, very thin line from where these stop to the inside corner of my eyes so that they blend a little bit better. You're watching me mess up. There. Okay, I blended it with my finger. Alright, so that looks okay. My lips look bigger now. Selfie time now. Oh, that side looks a little uneven, actually. I think I need a little more liner. There. So here we go. My slightly messy hair down. Hope you enjoyed my makeup tutorial.